مشاهدينا الكرام، هنكمل معاكم فعاليات اخر يوم من معرض سيتي سكيب دبي 2016، خليكم معانا.
Mirror Central is located on the very west coast of the rocks. There are churches efficiently around, allowing left turns and every junction, no use of the service zone. This is the type of common ground we're imagining in the future of the bar. We have the tram coming right into the centre, bringing train stations closer together to make it convenient for people, connecting to existing bus routes throughout the bar. Planning for the future, driverless cars, driverless shuttles, the way that's going to be in the future, we're planning to manage Mirror Central.
Our first ever central station located right here on the corner of Shadeside Road and Hawksbeam Street. This central station will allow people to exchange
and animated activated throughout the overall.
This is city retail, it's not a shopping mall. It's every type of retail in the hierarchy of retail right from the over in Lego Park and the shops and inside.
We have 40 office buildings. From A grade corporate staff to mentor and to respond to that for the residential.
Our parking strategy is innovative as well. The lights you see here are 21 different park environments designed to promote community. We don't just have one large park for a group of people around it, there are 33 parks around the entire environment. And it's all about putting people in the centre of the action.
Underpinning the master planning is sustainability, wellness, smart cities, all those things that are very master plan is designed to be used. It's much more for us to go away from
it. We all step out across the landscape. It's an enormous part of the city, but the chances of running the sun are pretty big, unless you do it since the third thing is adaptability. This very, very thoughtful, grid-like master plan enables us to create a city that's not just exciting to our sensibilities now, but is able to accommodate and adapt as life changes. Our whole world has changed in the last 10 years. Internet, mobile phones, apps that help disrupt industries to create greater customer convenience. As expectations we have.
Carolina.
we're rolling. Ask us.
Good evening. We're having Mr. Crest Roberts, the CEO of Iltizam Group. Good evening, sir.
Hi, good evening.
May you please tell us a brief history about the company?
Sure. Iltizam originally started back in 2009, but since that period, we've grown to be more of an asset management company, and particularly now we have multi-organizations that look after different facets of the real estate and the facilities and community management business.
Can you tell me about the projects you're implementing right now?
Okay, here we're displaying Horizon Towers, which is on Ream Island. We've got a number of units for sale from our Remax 360 business. But also we're here also with 360 Communities, which is now the largest community management company in the UAE. We've got over 80 buildings in total, with well over 20,000 units.
You're not thinking of expanding like outside the UAE?
Not for 2016 and 17, but possibly into 2018, very much looking then the GCC and how we grow our market further afield then after that. But for the moment, it's very much consolidating our position because we've grown quite rapidly in the last couple of years. So consolidate our services and our position in the UAE.
You're not thinking about the MENA region?
Definitely. I mean, that's more about 2018. So for us, first of all, we're looking at Saudi Arabia, Qatar markets, as well as Egypt as well. And thereafter then into the wider field after that point.
What do you think about like the real estate investment sector in the MENA region and the UAE and like the world?
I think particularly in the UAE, still a very positive market. Yes, there has been a downturn the last couple of years, but that's driven from a natural correction anyway. So I think particularly with the amount of numbers here at Cityscape and the amount of people are here anyway, the market is still very buoyant. And particularly now Q4 in 2016 and Q1, you are going to see a stabilization and increase in prices, particularly in Dubai, and then probably Q1 and Q2 back into Abu Dhabi.
We're saying today it's the last day in Cityscape. How was it? And like, is this the first time you come to an exhibit in Cityscape?
No. We do it every year. For us, it's a very important presentation for us. We do Abu Dhabi at the same time as well. And we're very key. This is one of our key growth areas and key growth markets. So for us to be here is very important for us.
Are you looking forward to escape Egypt?
Inshallah, in time. Yes, hopefully, inshallah. Yes.
Thank you so much, Mr. Crest. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
The inspiration for Jira Central, this 4.4 million square meter master plan, comes from His Highness's vision of bringing more tourists to Dubai, to reinforcing our regional hub status in the Middle East, creating a happy and inclusive society where walkability and people. Jira Central is located on the very basic aspect of the rocks that are intuitive, intimately arranged, allowing left turns at every junction, no user, no service zone. This is the type of common ground we're imagining in the future of the bar. We have the tram coming right into the centre, bringing transportation closer together to make it convenient for people, connecting to existing bus routes throughout the bar. Planning for the future, driverless cars, driverless shuttles, whatever that's going to be in the future, we're currently going to have a zero central. Walking is a key way of transport.
Our first ever central station located right here on the corner of Shadeside Road.
Iltizam Asset Management. In a country progressing at a speed never before seen, it is invaluable to know that you can rely on a group that focuses on quality and service in order to maintain a steadfast market share in an ever-changing industry. Iltizam Asset Management is a group of companies specializing in an integrated approach to quality services in asset property and facilities management with associated support services. We are your partner when developing your portfolio in the Middle East. Each part of our business can be broken down into the individual market-focused companies. However, on a group level, our mission has always been to enhance brand reputations that work on upgrading our clients' asset value. We work on a level beyond just offering a service and have evolved the point of view and passion of our team to work with a strong commitment to delivering exceptional solutions to our clients every step of the way. Everybody is looking for something different in their investment planning and strategy for business growth. Our job is to offer as much as possible to the client and add value to their portfolio and maximize the growth of their investment, whether that's real estate, transportation, or critical FM services. We have three core objectives that sum up the way we look at everything we do. We control the asset by utilizing our subsidiary companies. We do everything to protect the client's asset and client's brand. We increase the return on investment by reducing costs and driving efficiencies. We hold these values close to our mindset and maintain strong vision on our leadership to uphold these values. Iltizam Asset Management Group is a committed partner every step of the way. We are ready to discover your vision and hear about how we can work with you to enhance the emotional and financial value of both your assets and your brand. Through our seamless operational expertise and years of extensive experience. We are committed, professional, passionate, dedicated to excellence.
We're having Mr. Ahmed Al-Ashar, the general manager of Tashir Company. Good evening.
Yes, hi, how are you?
Can you please tell us about the company?
Our company is Tashir.com. We are e-commerce company and advertising and marketing for real estate company. Any company in Dubai, we can make social media for any company and the digital marketing. We can make also a CEO for any website. We make promote for any events. Media company means from A to Z, from printing, business card, brochure, until we can make advertise in TV, in magazine, in Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, any website we can do also with advertising.
What clients do you have right now?
Until now we have like from the exhibition start until now like 12 big company in our we make it for him social media. You know now social media is all people use mobile and nobody can use a little bit magazine and TV, but all company now looking for social media and digital marketing to increase his follow or his like for his page. Digital marketing, it help any company and the cheap price also all people now see any company in Facebook or Instagram or Snapchat, any new, nobody now sit in TV or sit in magazine, but we can make also advertising in magazine and in any company wanted to make advertising in magazine, in TV, in any place, we can also in board, we can do also A to Z, from A to Z. Tashir.com, we make advertising from A to Z for any company, social media, advertising, marketing, e-commerce, anything we can do.
So Cityscape was a success for you now?
Yes, of course. Any events is successful for us. We wait any exhibition coming in Dubai. Actually, all company come in World Trade Center to make marketing. We are help any company to make marketing. We come to help him. If World Trade Center help him for marketing, also we help him for to make good marketing.
Thank you so much, Mr. Ahmed. We're looking forward to help.
So much for you. Thank you so much.
The inspiration for Jumeirah Central, this 4.4 million square metre master plan, comes from his famous vision of bringing more tourists to Dubai, to reinforcing our regional hub status in the Middle East, creating a happy and inclusive society where walkability and people are good. Jumeirah Central is located on the very west coast of the country. They are intuitive, easy to navigate around, allowing left turns in every country, no user, no service area. This is the type of common ground we're imagining in the future of the bar. We have the tram coming right into the centre, bringing transportations closer together to make it convenient for people, connecting to existing bus routes throughout the bar. Planning for the future, driverless cars, driverless shuttles, whatever that's going to be in the future, we're accommodating that as well as central. Walking is the key mode of transport.
First ever Central Station, located right here on the corner of Shadeside Road and Hawksbeam Street. The Central Station will allow people to exchange
animated activated right there on the mountain.
This is city retail, it's not a shopping mall. It's every type of retail in the hierarchy of retail right in Tokyo or the Tango Drive on the Shops and Inside.
We have 40 office buildings, running from any great corporate dispatch.
Our parking strategy is innovative as well. The lights you see here are 21 different park environments designed to promote community. We don't just have one large park for a group of people around it, there are 33 parks around the entire environment. And it's all about putting people in the centre of the action.
Another thing that master planning is sustainability, wellness, smart cities, all those things that are very master plan is designed to be saved. It's a special way of mindset.
We're all
sitting
down across the landscape. It's an enormous city, but the chances of finding the sun unless you go to see the sun. The third thing is that building is very, very thoughtful, grid-like master plan enables us to create a city that's not just exciting to our sensibilities now, but is able to accommodate and adapt as life changes. Our whole world has changed in the last 10 years. Internet, mobile phones, apps that help disrupt industries to create greater customer convenience. As expectations increase.
Just like this. Yeah. The inspiration for Jumeirah Central, this 4.4 million square metre master plan, comes from His Highness's vision of bringing more tourists to Dubai, to reinforcing our regional hub status in the Middle East, to creating a happy and inclusive society where walkability and people are good. The inspiration for Jumeirah Central, this 4.4 million square metre master plan, comes from His Highness's vision of bringing more tourists to Dubai, to reinforcing our regional hub status in the Middle East, to creating a happy and inclusive society where walkability and people are good. Jumeirah Central is located on the very west coast of the rocks that are intuitive, ancient valley of Iran, allowing left hand to every country, no user, no service zone. This is the type of common ground we're imagining in the future of Dubai. We have the trail putting the riding to the centre, bringing transportation closer together to make it convenient for people, connecting to existing bus routes throughout Dubai. Planning for the future, driverless cars, driverless shuttles, whatever that's going to be in the future, we're accommodating that in Jumeirah Central. Walking is a key way of transportation.
The first ever central station located right here on the corner of Shadeside Road and Hawksbeam Street. The central station will allow people.
دلوقتي معانا مستر ريمون خزامي السي او بتاع شركه ثرايا. ازي حضرتك؟
مرحبا، كيف الحال؟ الحمد لله.
حضرتك ممكن تكلمنا عن تاريخ الشركه؟
الشركه عمرها 20 سنه في الشارقه في مجال البناء والعقار والتطوير والمقاولات. نحن اليوم في مارا سيتي سكيب موجودين هون لنطلق مشروع برج صحارى 6 اللي هو موجود ورانا هون، اللي هو الجوهره تبع مجمع صحارى في الشارقه. برج صحارى 6 ابتدأنا في القواعد، وصلنا تقريبا لعند الأرض وأطلقنا في المبيعات المبدئية بأول شهر 6. من أول شهر 6 لليوم الحمد لله عندنا إقبال كبير عليه، وهلأ أطلقناه أوفيشالي بمعرض سيتي سكيب 15 في دبي، والإقبال عليه كويس والنتائج كويسة الحمد لله.
في أي مشاريع تانية غير برج صحارى؟
ايه هلا طبعا في مشاريع مستقبليه في الشارقه قيد الدراسه وقيد التحضير.
مش بتفكروا تتوسعوا برا الشارقه، في الامارات، في اي بلد عربي، في اي بلد تاني؟
طبعا عندنا توجه في نعمل بناء في دبي، بس مش على بيع شركات، لان الشركه بتملك اراضي هنا في دبي، بس على صعيد بنايات تاجير او نحتفظ فيها او نرجع نبيعها، بس مش كوحدات سكنيه. الوحدات السكنيه حتكون مينلي في اماره الشارقه.
المره الكامل اللي بتنزلوا فيها سيتي سكيب، وهل سيتي سكيب هو مركز بالنسبه لكم مهم؟
طبعا هيدي المره الخامسه يعني بننزل في سيتي سكيب. نحن بنطلع فيه من سنه لسنه، لان كثير بالنسبه لنا معرض سيتي سكيب، وخاصه بنترك مشاريعنا الجديده كلها فيها هنا.
كنت حابه اسمع راي حضرتك في الاقتصاد، وفي العقارات، يعني سوق العقارات في دبي وفي الوطن العربي.
طبعا هو سوق العقارات هو من اهم سوق في يعني المؤشر العمار، هو المؤشر الوضع الاقتصادي بالبلد يعني، ووضع دبي خاصة والإمارات عامة يعني في سوق العقار ناجح جدا وكويس جدا، ومن أهم مؤشرات فيه هو سوق العقار في دبي.
شكرا جدا مستر ريمون، ونتمنى ان نشوف حضرتك في مصر قريب جدا
ان شاء الله يا رب. شكرا لك. شكرا لك. شكرا.
The inspiration for Jumeirah Central, this 4.4 million square meter master plan, comes from His Highness's vision of bringing more tourists to Dubai, to reinforcing our regional hub status in the Middle East, to creating a happy and inclusive society where walkability and people are good. Jumeirah Central is located on the very west coast of
the rocks that are intuitive, ancient valley of Iran, allowing left turns in every country. This is the type of common ground we're imagining in the future of Dubai. We have the trail putting the riding to the centre, bringing transportation closer together to make it convenient for people, connecting to existing bus routes throughout Dubai. Planning for the future, driverless cars, driverless shuttles, whatever that's going to be in the future, we're accommodating that in Jumeirah Central. Walking is a key way of transportation.
First ever.
Central Station, located right there on the corner of Shadeside Road and Hawks Beach Street. This central station will allow people.
Executive member of Wadi Istanbul. Good evening, sir.
Hello, welcome to our project.
Thank you. Can you tell us a brief history about the company?
Yeah, sure. Artash Holding is one of the biggest real estate developers in Turkey. The group have delivered 17,000 apartments in the last 9 years. We have 4 shopping malls under operation and 2 under construction, 4 hotels, and we have 7 projects which is going on, and 6 which is already with the permits to be done again. So we can mention about yearly of $2 up to $3 billion of total construction project upcoming. And now we are here with 3 of our projects, which one of them is Wadi Istanbul, which is the biggest office complex of all Europe. It has totally 1,350,000 square meter of total construction. It has all life functions inside, the mall, offices, 5-star hotel and residence. And it's in a very accessible area of Istanbul. We have the new Ataşehir office project, which is the high-end office project in the Asia side now, developed by the group. And it will be finished in 2 years period. The construction had begun. And at the back, we have the Tema Istanbul project, which is, again, a huge project with 2.2 million square meters total when all stages are finished. The first stage with 3,500 apartments is ready already. Living people begin to living inside. The second stage has an amusement park and a shopping mall and 600 apartments also, which it began the project phase. And the third stage is expected to begin the construction in 2 years. So now we have, as I mentioned, 6 projects going on and sales. In most of them, the group's biggest reputation is the early delivery and highest income increase.
So your only projects are in Turkey?
Yeah, only we are just developing projects right now in Turkey, but after our fairs in Europe and here, we had lots of offers to make development in different countries. But the local expertise and experience is amazing, important, this thing. So we are one of the best thing at what we do. And now our highest experience is in Turkey, and we are doing it as much as good as we can.
I want to ask, why is it so important that you exhibit at Cityscape Dubai, as like you don't have projects in the Middle East?
The issue is that Turkey is one of the biggest real estate markets in the whole world. And because of its potential power, Istanbul is going to be leading in the world real estate market. We are speaking about 17 million population, which is bigger than most of the countries in Europe, even bigger than the Emirates or the other countries in the whole Gulf. And thanks to God, our brothers in Gulf in all Gulf area, Saudi, Dubai, just UAE or Kuwait, they feel themselves very comfortable and happy when they are spending time in Turkey. There's lots of things in common, and they can see high quality lifestyle with all kind of necessities served well, and they have the just their, let I say, all cultural things that like Islamic halal food and azan and everything. So day by day, the potential interest of all Gulf to Turkey is increasing. The most important part that they have to find what they need. And recently, with the new upcoming real estate developments, we are just widening the range. So every year they will find more efficient projects in Turkey to live in, not only to buy and sell and get investment value. One of the important parts of Istanbul is a huge city with a huge population and lots of different lifestyles. Every next visit you can find something else to live, to experience in Istanbul. That makes it exciting, and the number of the tourists visiting Istanbul increases day by day. Another important thing is just for the real estate market to have a good quality vision, there must be a serious interior domestic demand. Because of the population and young people, it's huge in Istanbul. Whether you don't sell to abroad, there is an amazing power of the domestic necessity. So if we add the foreigner interest on this, we are speaking about huge potential. And you can see the projects attending from Turkey. They are high visioned, amazing magnitude projects, which very, very efficiency investment opportunities. So this was another point of view that we are coming here. We wanted to show the power of Istanbul real estate market here. When you see our stand, when you see our projects, when you just, when we are mentioning about the huge square meters and huge revenues, even you don't have any idea about Istanbul, you are beginning to think about it. So thanks to God, this is the last day of the fair, but it was very efficient. And we had serious contacts. Inshallah, we are going to keep them up when we go back, because when we are speaking about really big investment opportunities, it's not so easy to make sales here. But I do believe so, we are going to achieve 3-4 successful sales operations that we have connected here.
It seems like a very, very large company with many projects, and we're hoping that you would invest in UAE, in Egypt or in the Middle East, that you use this investment.
Sure, to be honest, we are thinking of that. As you reach to us a certain amount of powers, you must expand it. You cannot say that I'm staying here. That's a reason that we are seeking to make some achievements. We are evaluating some offers. But to be honest, if we decide to enter this market, we will be focusing to be the best. So it's not that easy. We are just waiting for the correct land development or correct project that we can be proudly entering the market. So
we hope to see you in Cityscape Abu Dhabi, the Kuwait and Egypt very soon.
Maybe we are going to attend Abu Dhabi Cityscape in Saudi, but Abu Dhabi is another chance. Next year we will take this in consideration. Yeah.
We're going to wait for you. Thank you, sir.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.
The inspiration for Jira Central, this 4.4 million square meter master plan, comes from His Highness's vision of bringing more tourists to Dubai, to reinforcing our regional hub status in the Middle East, to creating a happy and inclusive society where walkability and people live. Jira Central is located on the very busy Pacific Ocean rocks. They're intuitive, each and every around, allowing left hand in every country. This is the type of common ground we're imagining in the future of the bar. We have the tram coming right into the center, bringing transportations closer together to make it convenient for people, connecting to existing bus routes throughout the bar. Planning for the future, driverless cars, driverless shuttles, the way that's going to be in the future, we're accommodating that in Europe Central. Walking is a key way of transport.
That first ever central station located right there on the corner of Shadeside Road, Street. The central station will allow people to exchange
This
is city retail, it's not a shopping mall.
برشا شباب مجمع سبراتو بادي مجمع كتير كبير سبعة بلوك ملاعب مسابح نادي رياضي فيه كمان كراج مفتوح فيه كراج مسكر فيه ملعب كرة سلة ساونا وجاكوزي وفيتنس. شوي في عنا المركز الرياضي فيه حمام وساونا وجاكوزي ونادي رياضي كامل منفصل البنات عن الشباب. يعني الشباب بيكون مثلا إذا يوم وبيكون البنات يوم وفي أيام بتكون فيها مختلطة. منلاقي هون في عنا المجمع البلوكات اللي فيه يعني 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 هن البلوكات الخاصين بالمجمع. فهذا كله هو يعتبر المجمع نفسه. منلاقي في عنا كراج مفتوح حول المجمع وملاقي في عنا كراج مسكر يلي بيكون تحت المجمع تماما. في عنا هونيك بالضبط صاير ورا البناء لونه أبيض هو البازار. فهذا بازار كتير كبير بنعمل هون في المنطقة. هو أكبر بازار موجود في بهشاشة. على اليمين هونيك الأوتو بارك تبع البازار.
To reinforcing our regional hub status in the Middle East, to creating a happy and inclusive society where walkability and people are good. Jumeirah Central is located on the very west coast of the rocks that are intuitive, intimately around, allowing left turns at every junction, no user, no service road. This is the type of common ground we're imagining in the future of the bar. We have the trail coming right into the centre, bringing transportation closer together to make it convenient for people, connecting to existing bus routes throughout the bar. Planning for the future, driverless cars, driverless shuttles, the way that's going to be in the future, we're accommodating that as well as central. Walking is the key way we're trying to pick
the first ever central station located right here on the corner of Shadeside Road and Hawks Beach Street. This central station will allow people to exchange
the week and make it activated throughout the overall.
Every type of retail in the hierarchy of retail, right from the old, the Lego Park and the shops and insects.
We have 40 office buildings, everything from A grade corporate dispatch to metro and can respond to that to your residential
shop. Car parking strategy is innovative as well. The lights you see here are 21 different car park environments designed to promote community. We don't just have one large park for a group of people around it, there are 33 parks around the entire environment. And it's all about putting people in the center of the action.
Underpinning the master planning is sustainability, wellness, smart cities, all those things that every master plan is designed to be based. It's quite important for us to be mindful.
We want to see a better across the landscape.
We're having Mr. Karim Baroudi, the marketing director of Mazay. Good evening, sir.
Hi, good evening.
Can you please tell us a brief history about the company?
We are Al-Mazay Real Estate. We are one of the largest developer in the region. We have a development in Dubai, Saudi Arabia, Qatar, Bahrain, Oman, definitely Kuwait, the holding level in Kuwait. And now we knock the doors of Turkey. One of our projects in Turkey is substantially completed.
Can you tell us about the projects you're implementing right now?
Actually, the majority of our projects successfully has been handed over and sold out. We are the first who come up with an experience of an affordable housing segment, and we already start developing over there, and out of the development that we have, 4,100 units already has been handed over and completed. And now, after the success that we have it in that segment of that top affordable housing, we are launching phase two of that, and that phase two consists of four buildings. And we have a very good response this year in the market.
I can see like the success of Cityscape. I would like to know like how important is Cityscape for you?
Actually, we've been participating in Cityscape as Mazaya for the last 13 years. And this year, we really see a very, very, very positive response. In fact, we have a lot of queries, a lot of reservations, a lot of interest in the market, especially when it comes to the type and segment of products that we are providing.
So you're participating in every Cityscape or like just in the UAE?
No, actually we have some experience to participate in other Cityscape in the region, but UAE for us it's a must. Dubai especially, it's a must. We have to be there and we always been there.
Are you thinking of expanding like outside the Gulf area?
Actually yes, we are looking right now. We start knock doors internationally, and I think shortly we'll be hearing some good news.
Okay, we're looking forward to like in Egypt.
Actually, yeah, this is one of the regions that we are, I mean, we are considering right now. But I think internationally it's going to be a little bit more far than Egypt.
I would like to know, like, your opinion about the real estate sector, like in the MENA region, the Gulf, the world, and how it affects the economy.
The point is, like, when it comes to Dubai, there is always demand. The market is really healthy and there is always demand. Yes, there might be a little bit correction in terms of price, but that correction is something really healthy. And it's in some stage, it turns to attract the people to come buy again in Dubai. Because when the price goes high, it's definitely we as an expert, we don't advise the customer to buy. Actually, after the correction, which the timing that we have right now, it is the right price to, is it the right time, sorry, to buy. So the correction is always healthy. We didn't experience much in terms of price correction because the demand in our type of products, the affordable housing, is really high. So the prices didn't face much changes like 30 and 40% in the luxury products or luxury apartments and houses in Dubai. However, now we see the picking up again in market and we see a very good response in Cityscape.
Thank you so much, Mr. Karim. We hope to see you soon.
Thank you very much for your time. Thank you, guys.
Al-Mazaya Holding Company is widely recognized as one of the most important and reputable real estate development companies in the Middle East, with numerous impressive projects in its portfolio. The company is based on a belief in the need for strong, rigorous investment in the region. Al-Mazaya was founded in Kuwait in 2004. Based in Kuwait and Dubai, and operating projects in Saudi Arabia, Lebanon, Abu Dhabi, Oman and Qatar, Al-Mazaya has interests to extend to other parts of the GCC and MENA region, including Turkey, Jordan, Egypt, and Morocco. a testimony to its continued vertical and lateral growth. Al-Mazaya is duly listed on the Kuwait Stock Exchange and the Dubai Financial Market. Al-Mazaya has sustained a strong copyright for the company with an exclusive intent to provide superior real estate services through the region and the MENA market. Al-Mazaya provides a variety of comprehensive real estate products and services in several fields. Among these are housing projects, commercial projects, and health projects. Briefly, Al-Mazaya's services can be summarized as follows. Real estate development, project management, marketing management, property management, portfolio and fund management, real estate valuation, research, royal brokerage. Al-Mazaya Holding has a number of reliable and respected subsidiary organizations across the various countries in the GCC region, dealing with different aspects of the real estate market. Among them are First Dubai Real Estate Development Company, First Qatar Real Estate Development Company, Seven Zones Real Estate Company in Kuwait, Al-Mazaya Real Estate and Al-Dana Real Estate Limited in Dubai, and Al-Mazaya Lebanon. Al-Mazaya Holding's organizational team is made up of two highly talented sets of realty personnel with a comprehensive understanding of regional markets, one based in Kuwait and the other in Dubai. Al-Mazaya has continued to achieve growth in its results since its inception with a conservative, low-risk business strategy. The value of Al-Mazaya Holding Company's projects add up to around $2 billion. These include a wide range of ventures, from exclusive villa communities and plush residential apartments to state-of-the-art commercial spaces, including office, business, and healthcare centers, extending to all parts of the GCC region. With a substantial interest in the healthcare sector, among Al-Mazaya's initiatives are projects which include medical centers, health clubs, and health resorts. With the ever-expanding demand for office space, Al-Mazaya has broadened its portfolio by investing in office projects in the Middle East. In Kuwait, wherever they are located, Al-Mazaya developments are renowned far and wide. This is demonstrated by our many notable projects, including residential projects, Yammar Cultural Village, Al-Ru'ya Tower in Al-Mahbula, Al-Maha Villas in Gulf Road, Salwa, Al-Mazaya Villas in Kuwait, commercial projects, Seven Zone, health projects, Clover Center in Al Jabriya, office projects, the Global Tower, Mazaya Towers in KDT, Nira Financial Hub. In the UAE, meanwhile, a number of Al Mazaya projects add to the Emirates' luminosity and luxury. A selection in different cities include Abu Dhabi, Marina in Reem Island, Dubai Land in Dubai, The Villa, Q Point, in Dubai Healthcare City, The Icon, Mazaya Business Avenue, Indigo, Sky Gardens in Dubai. In 2013, Al-Mazaya won the prestigious Super Brand Kuwait Award for the third time. Other awards Al-Mazaya has received include Most Admired Company by Arabian Business News, The Best Real Estate Company by Arabian Business News, The GCC's Most Admired Company by Construction Week. Al-Mazaya believes that a company needs to be responsible for its actions, socially, ethically, and environmentally. A fundamental pillar of our philosophy is to manage our business processes in a way which produces an overall positive impact on society, shaping our vision of the future beyond what we have seen. Al-Mazaya, a special name for a special sign.
To reinforcing our regional hub status in the Middle East, creating a happy and inclusive society where walkability and people are good. Jumeirah Central is located on the very west coast of the rocks that are intuitive, efficient and around, allowing left turn in every country when you use that service road. This is the type of common ground we're imagining in the future of the bar. We have the tram coming right into the centre, bringing transportations closer together to make it convenient for people, connecting their existing bus routes throughout the bar. Planning for the future, driverless cars, driverless shuttles, whatever that's going to be in the future, we're accommodating that as well as central.
We're having Mr. Joseph Clindesen, the chairman of Clindesen Group. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Can you please tell us a brief history about the company?
The Clindesen Group is more than 30 years old, and we are in Dubai since 2003. We are happy and we are proud. We are the biggest European real estate company here in Dubai, and we are developer and we are real estate investors.
Can you tell us about the projects you're implementing right now?
So we have started construction on our project, The Heart of Europe. It's a six-island project within Dubai's The World project. And our most famous product, we are building hotels, we are building villas, and we are building floating villas. The Floating Seahorse is the name, with one room underwater. You can live inside the ocean.
That's really cool. But is it only in Dubai? You're not in any other city or country?
Also we are, our company is in 11 different countries as development company and as investment company.
Can you tell us about the projects in other countries rather than the UAE?
Yeah, for example, now if you go to Seychelles Islands, it's 4-hour flight from here. We had a big investment in a touristic project there, and it's completed. Now we have de-invested, and we bring our money to Dubai, because Dubai at the moment is worldwide the number one place for real estate investment.
I can see the success in Cityscape at your booth. So can you tell us about how important Cityscape is to your company?
Yes, Cityscape is the number one exhibition for the real estate business here in Dubai. And everyone in this business should be here as exhibitor or as visitor to understand what's going on in the market and to meet with all the relevant people in this industry.
Do you usually participate in any other Cityscape or rather than Dubai?
We will also participate in Cityscape in Saudi Arabia in beginning of November.
Thank you so much, Mr. Joseph.
Thank you very much.
The inspiration for Jumeirah Central, this 4.4 million square meter master plan, comes from His Highness's vision of bringing more tourists to Dubai, to reinforcing our regional hub status in the Middle East, to creating a happy and inclusive society where walkability and people are good. Jumeirah Central is located on the very west coast of the rocks. They're intuitive, efficient navigating around, allowing left turns in every country when you use that service road. This is the type of common ground we're imagining in the future of the bar. We have the tram coming right into the centre, bringing transportations closer together to make it convenient for people, connecting their existing bus routes throughout the bar. Planning for the future, driverless cars, driverless shuttles, whatever that's going to be in the future, we're accommodating that as Jumeirah Central. Walking is the key way of transport.
First ever central station located right here on the corner of Shadeside Road and Hawks Beach Street. This central station will allow people to exchange
the week and make it activated throughout the overall region.
This is city retail, it's not a shopping mall. It's every type of retail in the hierarchy of retail right from the over and they go drive on the shops and incidents.
We have 40 office buildings. Everything from A grade corporate dispatch to much more, and can respond to that to the real estate community.
Our parking strategy is innovative as well. The lights you see here are 21 different parking environments designed to promote community. We don't just have one large park for a group of people around it, there are 33 parks that are at the entire environment. And it's all about putting people in the center of the action.
Underpinning the master planning is sustainability, wellness, smart cities, all those things that are every master plan is designed to be. It's a special work for us to put away mindset.
City, where the chances of running in the sun are pretty big, unless you hear it seems to be done. The third thing is adaptability. This very, very thoughtful grid-like master plan enables us to create a city that's not just exciting to our sensibilities now, but is able to accommodate and adapt as life changes. Our whole world has changed in the last 10 years. Internet, mobile phones, apps that help disrupt industries to create greater customer convenience. As expectations we have.
وبكده نكون وصلنا لآخر يوم من فعاليات سيتي سكيب دبي في الورلد تريد سنتر. كنت معاكم رنا شعبان من قناة العقارية في دبي.